Hello, this is Kenneth Nichols for Great Writers Steal. Today we are going to learn what we can steal from John Cheever's reunion. This short story was published in 1962 in the August pages of the New Yorker. You can find it in any anthology out there because it's in a bunch of them. You'll also find a link in the description because the New Yorker posted a file of Richard Ford reading you the story. Very nice of them. The element of craft that we're stealing, the communication of pathos. That's emotion, obviously. What is Reunion about? It's a short story as well as a powerful one. Charlie, the first-person narrator, recounts the brief reunion he had with his father. Charlie's a child at the time, and all he wanted to do with his father was have a good day. But Dad had other ideas. All they do is go out and drink, and finally Charlie gets on in the train, never to see his father again. The narrator is so calm in the story, even though you know there's a lot of emotion wrapped up in the experience. One way that you can tell is because Mr. Cheever puts a frame around the story. Here's the first sentence. The last time I saw my father was in Grand Central Station. And here's the last one. Goodbye, Daddy, I said. And I went down the stairs and got my train, and that was the last time I saw my father. There's a symmetry to this story, as though the narrator's closed a chapter of his life and has made it clear to the reader that he has no more to say on the subject. You don't have to be told explicitly. You can feel the closing of a door. There's further repetition at the end of the story. Charlie calls his father Daddy 3 times. 3's a magic number, isn't it? Can you hear the different tones in which young Charlie would use the word? First, calmness. Second, sadness. And thirdly, emotional detachment. You are free to have differing opinions, but you see the point. Cheever packs a lot of pathos into Reunion without really offering much explicit insight into the narrator's thoughts. Instead, future Charlie is reporting the events, and we are invited to make our own conclusions as to what he is feeling. Doesn't this mimic the process by which we do the same thing in our own relationships? Let's break it down. What should we steal? Let's employ repetition to communicate emotion. It's often far more fulfilling to understand something by figuring out the subtext instead of simply being told. This is also the way that so many emotions are communicated in real life. A dissatisfied significant other, for example, may not sit you down and tell you how they feel. Those people will, however, repeatedly treat you in a manner that should clue you in as to how they feel. Secondly, make use of 3, the magic number. 3 just feels natural for some reason. Beginning, middle, end. Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Larry, Moe, Curly. Tinker, whoever is the chance. That's all I have to say for this one. Remember, you can always subscribe to the channel or check out my website at www.greatwritersteal.com. And remember, Shakespeare did it, so should you.